Hello everyone, this is another video lecture on the poem The Scholar Gypsy by Matthew Arnold, and I am Temu Serpa, assistant professor at Mecklenburg College in the Department of English. Speaking about the poem, I would like to tell you about Matthew Arnold and what are the features what are the features that we find in him that makes him a classical or a classicist. So what is first I would like to start with the definition of classicism. So by classicism it means by definition it means an any work of art which embodies Greek or Hellenic or Roman spirit. And the features of classicism are rationalism, as they are the people who think with the head and not with the heart, rather like the romantics. And next is cold formalism, that is they are distant in treatment of emotions. Like for example, what you find in romanticism are feelings and emotions, and just opposite to that, cold formalism is a feature of classicism, and objectivity and impersonal. So how Arnold is a classicist? He is deeply influenced by Hellenic or Greek spirit. His poetry or this particular poem, The Scholar Gypsy, it imbibes a Greek spirit. He uses classical classics as a mode for his poem. And this is a quotation by Matthew Arnold, where he says where we find his definition of poem. To him, poetry is simply the most beautiful, impressive, and widely effective modes of saying things. So he always emphasized on the idea of whole, that also makes him a classicist, because and opposite to beauty that talks about different parts. Okay, so poetry must not lose itself into parts. So this idea of seeing a unity, believing in unity, is what makes him a classicist. And in The Scholar Gypsy, he achieves this unity and action, his representation of the Victorian. So he actually achieves this unity when he represents her Victorian period as a whole. So next we have poetry. Arnold always sees poetry as a criticism of life, he says that poetry should not lose itself in parts, as I already said, and poetry should attempt to realize an ideal life. It should lead us to an ideal life, a life that is purposeful. So poetry should represent truth, okay, and it should always deal with higher seriousness. It should have high seriousness, so it should be intellectual from the head. And there are also features that makes him a romantic poet at times, but he is mostly a classicist. So when I am saying he's not a romantic, so let me define what romanticism means. So romanticism in literature embodies free expression of feeling, and artists, they mostly believe in imagination, and they always believe poetry as a spontaneous flow of emotion, as Wordsworth say that by definition he defines poetry as a spontaneous flow of emotion collected in tranquility. And unlike classicism, it is always subjective and personal. So Arnold is also a romanticist, but only in his treatment of nature, because we find some nature as a background in his poem, that also makes him also slightly romantic. So because we have this pastoral setting, Oxford Elegy. So however, unlike romanticists, his treatment of nature is very accurate, and nature only gives him peace and not joy. Wordsworth, nature was also a nurturer, was something that he is always going back to for power, for for joy. But to him, nature was only a peaceful setting. He only uses nature as a setting. So we also find romanticism in the sense that the poem talks about escapism. It wants to escape from that, it wants to escape from this quote-unquote term, sick hurriness of the time. So Sikh Hariness, that represents Victorian age, and the scholar Gypsy is actually trying to escape from that. He is in a quest to escape that. So in if the this theme of escapism that we find in Arnold's poem also makes it a kind of romantic poem. So again, why it is again, and it also makes gives a kind of personal or objective view, because he talks about his own doubts and loss of faith in the poem. And similarly, Arnold is also a precursor of modern. So in between, in defining Arnold as a neoclassicist, as a strong classicist, and having slightly romantic features in his poem. Now next, we have what we get to see in his poem, and the scholar Gypsy, is that he is also working as a precursor, or he is also writing as a precursor of modernism and classicism. Similar to modernism, it talks about intellect and rationality, and they also see society as a whole. So what is the main difference between classicism and romanticism is that classicism, in classicism the things are predetermined and fixed, like some ordain that is destined to happen in near future. So that kind of predictions are there in classicism, whereas in romanticism is always about sufferance, about fragmentation, about world which has faced two world wars, and there is the spirit of questioning that we find in the spirit of questioning that we find in Arnold's poem, and the quest that is in which the scholar Gypsy is involved, also makes it very much modern. And there is this alienation, the theme of alienation, the loss of sense of identification with society, lacking purpose in life, meaninglessness leads to meaninglessness, which is also another feature of existentialism, that each half life, so this is taken from the poem, each half lives a 100 different lives in an age of Sikh Hari. So the Victorian age is defined as an age of Sikh Hari with divided ends and paralyzed hearts, and they wait like thee but not like thee in hope, so hopelessness. So all these are the themes of existentialism that also makes Arnold a precursor of the romantic age. So having said that, I would like to conclude my presentation saying that Matthew Arnold, he was somewhat born before time, because we can see him as a precursor of modern age. So we can say that he was untimely born, that he was born before time, and that he was actually a misfit for the Victorian period. Thank you very much. This much for today.